Hello students, today we are going to discuss Unit 5, Topic 7 Quality Control Tools. These quality control tools help in identifying the problem so that solution will definitely come. As we all know that half of our problem will solve when we know the reasons. And these quality control tools are not only applicable in manufacturing sector but also applicable in different sectors. Now let's start with the first, that is flow chart or run chart or stratification. Okay. Now let's have a look on this flow chart. In this flow chart, what we do, we are simply make a flow chart of the whole production process, or we can say this is a simple visual representation of the process. In production and operations management, there are some standards to develop the flow chart. We know that this symbol represents the decision making. With the help of this flow chart, we have a clarity regarding the process, and so that we can diagnose the problem easily. Okay? Or we can say in operations management language, we can use this tool to identify the bottleneck of the process. Now move on to the next, that is check sheet. Check sheet are used for organizing and collecting data. Researchers are generally use this tool to collect data because it's a very convenient tool. And this can be understood with the help of this check sheet. On this y-axis there are defects, and on x-axis there are days, or we can say dates are mentioned, and this line represents the occurrence of this particular defect on this day. Okay, and the blank cell represents that there is no occurrence of this defect on this day. Okay, so let's have a look on this day, Tuesday. The three lines represents the occurrence of this defect on this particular day. This one line represents the defect, wrong part issued occurrence occurred one time on this Monday. Okay, so in future, later on, we convert this data into numerical data. Okay, or we can say this is a very simple tool to organize and collect the data. Now move on to the next, that is histogram. Histogram is simply the pictorial representation of the frequency with respect to the defects. Suppose we have a defects 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have suppose 12 defects. Okay. And the frequency. Frequency is on y-axis. So with the help of this histogram, it is very clear the number 3 defect. The number 3 defect are very common defect, and number 12 defect are very rare defect. So with the help of this defect, we identify which is more common defect and which is less common defect. Okay, now let's move on to the next, that is Pareto chart. Pareto chart is simply the rearrangement of the histogram. We have arranged the defects in decreasing order. Let's have a look on the histogram again. In histogram, we can see the more common defect are on second number, and very less are on the last number. Okay, so what we are doing in the Pareto analysis, we are arranging all these defects in a decreasing order, or we can say descending order. Okay, let's see. This is a Pareto chart. In this Pareto chart, we are arranging all the defects in a decreasing order. Okay, and this Pareto chart is based on the principle 80-20 rule. What is this 80-20 rule? 20% reasons are responsible for 80% of outcome, or we can say 20% of the employees are responsible for 80% of the performance. And in production and operations management, 20% items or issues are responsible for 80% of quality related problem. This is the 80-20 rule. Okay. And with the help of this Pareto analysis, We identify the right priority. This is my right priority. So we have to focus on this higher priority rather than this less priority area. So with the help of this Pareto analysis or Pareto chart, we focus on the right priority area and we don't want to waste our efforts on the less priority area. Okay. Now move on to the next, that is control chart. In this control chart, we have a upper control limit, that is UCL, and the lower control limit, that is LCL, and this is the target line which we want to achieve, and this represents the production process. If the values lies within the upper control limit and the lower control limit, then the product is acceptable. If the values go beyond the upper control limit and below the lower control limit, that is not an acceptable product. Okay, so we have to try that our product should lie within the upper control limit and the lower control limit. Okay, and this can be discussed in our next video, that is statistical quality control, where we can discuss this in a very detailed manner. Okay, now move on to the next, that is scattered diagram. It is helpful in identifying if there is a correlation between the value of two variables. If there is a relation between the two variables, then the line or the points are look like this. If there is no relation, then the values are scattered in this whole area. Okay, or we can say if there is a little relationship between the two variables, then the points would be completely scattered in this region. Okay, and this shows the relationship of the two variables. Now move on to the next, that is cause and effect diagram. This cause and effect diagram is popularly known as fishbone diagram and also known as Ishikawa diagram. This is look like a fishbone, that's why it is popular by the name of fishbone diagram. And what it is, let's have a look on this chart or this pictorial representation of this cause and effect diagram. This is the defect and these are the reasons of this defect and these are the sub reasons of the main reasons. Okay, so in this diagram we identify the possible reasons of this particular defect. Suppose this is a one defect and there are number of reasons of this defects. So with the help of very continuous brainstorming, we identify these reasons and the sub reasons of this main reasons, and we have to focus the possibilities of this defects, why this defect arises and which is the popular reason for this particular problem. So we have to focus on the various reasons and try to solve the defect. Okay, thank you students.